Hello everyone, I'd like to say hi to everyone out there and thank you for subscribing to my channel. I'd like to take one scripture from the beginning and put it where we are today. Why so many witnesses are leaving Watchtower's false teaching. And I'm going to use an example of Adam and compare his situation to Jehovah's Witnesses' teaching. Because it is disturbing how Watchtower has twisted the minds of the members all throughout the years. And it's sad. We have learned nothing truly from the Bible to be called Christians. To be a Christian, you have to know the scriptures throughout the Hebrew scriptures and the Greek scriptures. Without Watchtower's literature. Because I remember looking at their literatures, and I can see this in my head right now in different books. Especially on the 2,500 years from 607, and it takes you all the way down to 1914. And during the week, this week, Watchtower put up a video how to talk to your Bible study to explain that whole nonsense. And I'm not going to put up that video because it is nothing but nonsense, unscripture, unbiblical, and true history from historians has proven many times that 587 or 586 was the correct year, destruction of Jerusalem and the first temple. So I'm not putting up that video. But there's a lot of nonsense in there that it would have been good, but Watchtower done burned their butts and burned buns. Same thing. Trying to defend that lie. And I and others have proven. Different researches prove there's no scholar ever said 607 was the destruction of Jerusalem. You can believe it or don't believe it. That is your choice. But I am glad I did my research, and that makes me not ignorant of learning the real truth. So you can take that, Jehovah's Witnesses, any way you want to. This scripture, what I'm going to use, is going to be hitting you, your elders, and Watchtower, and your governing body. And it's Genesis 2:16. Wow, we got an airplane flying by. And the Lord God commanded to the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat. We don't know how many trees he was able to eat. We have no idea how big this garden was. It had to have been huge, because they never, him and Eve, never found the tree of life that God never told them that was in the garden. So from every tree they was eating from it, they never got close to that tree. Let's put that out first. Now, but of the tree of knowledge. Now remember this now. The key words here, knowledge of good and evil. And that's what we could be focusing on. You shall not eat, for in the day you eat from it, you will surely die. So, the key words is knowledge of good and evil. This is pointing to the religion that I was in. They convinced my parents and many people that they had the knowledge of good, and they didn't have the knowledge of evil. Everything was good. The thing I want to bring out, people, this scripture is a clue to all of us. Did I honestly gain my knowledge from the Bible when I was a Jehovah's Witness? No. I gained my knowledge of believing the elders. I'm going to get back to them. Believing the governing body and all their books and literature was supposed to be knowledge and good for us. Spiritual food, what they call it. The thing is, people, we know now why it was that tree of life for mankind was pure evil. Adam and Eve had any trees they could have ate from without touching that wicked tree. And no, touching the tree did not cause the problem. It was them listening to the serpent and picking it, the fruit, and she ate from it, gave it to Adam. Now, she didn't become naked till Adam ate from it. Because, think about it, if she ate from it, we don't know how many hours till she gave him the fruit. And then when he ate from it, that's when both their eyes become open. Because remember, she came from him. So it's weird in a way they was combined as one till Adam was infected by the poison she ate. Her eyes was not open to realize she was naked. And that's the best way I can put it. So the point is, people, we have been eating from that tree from Watchtower for many, many years. We ate from that tree of knowledge, good and evil, and not even known it. Because we never trusted the Bible. We had to have someone that was already indoctrinated in this corrupt, evil organization, this dangerous cult, to teach us from their own publications and lure us away from the real true knowledge of the Bible. So we took their knowledge, their goodness, and only believe the part of the evil was in other religion, or this case, part of the evil was in their own Bible. Think about it. When you go through the Bible and compare it to their superior Bible, and I went on Bible Hub, and if the NWT, I guess that's how would you say, yeah, the New World Testament was a superior Bible, why didn't Bible Hub put their Bible in there to be superior to all the other books, Bibles, on their website? Why? Could it be possible that they went through this book and it's not recognized by anyone to use it? And that's the reason why it's never considered to be called a Bible. People, we have to learn the truth. It's always been in the Bible. I was scared that I could not understand the Bible without the elders, without Watchtower, without the governing body, spirit directed this organization. Boy, I was wrong. Others found out same thing. We have to stop taking the fruit from Watchtower, literally or spiritually, because it is killing us. It is pure evil. The knowledge of that tree is what God told Adam. He gave him knowledge so he would not mess up. It was good for God to tell Adam where that tree of life was. Keep Adam from not accidentally stumble across that tree and not knowing where it was. But he did let him know how evil that tree would do. It would kill him. So everything in that verse was Adam's benefit, him and Eve. Just like it's our benefit to listen to different people who's trying to tell you something is wrong with this religion. It's our knowledge. It's our goodness from our heart. Because we was in this evil. That watchtower tried to keep us in their fake knowledge and their symbolic goodness. I was going to make a different video, and somehow this information was coming to me in a way that I had to make this video. I don't know how or what, but all I know, I can tell you this much. Adam and Eve messed up big time. But we don't have to mess up. We don't have to lose our lives, people. We can take that verse and seek the real knowledge of the Bible. I've done that. Others have done that. And we, even using their own book, found real truth pointed that watchtower has been lying to us for many years. And the good part is waking us up. And the other part is showing how the evil, what God told, what would happen to Adam and Eve if they ate from that tree. That same thing like us. We took it for granted. We thought we had knowledge. We thought that everybody in the kingdom hall was good-hearted Christians. But instead, this whole organization of Jehovah's Witnesses is pure evil. And it's right there in front of our face. In Genesis chapter 2, 16 and 17. You can't pass the buck and blame somebody else because you don't want to listen to us and do the research. Just like Eve. No, just like Adam, blame it on Eve. Eve blamed it upon the serpent. You are the one in power. And you had the power in your hands. It was God's word. To test all things. Make sure it is good. And will it help you gain eternal life? Or is it pure evil to take your life away? I hope this video will open your heart to true knowledge and understanding why we have to understand the scriptures of the Bible when the true tree that we're supposed to be finding is true knowledge, real good-hearted goodness, and no evil. And you cannot find those qualities in Jehovah's Witness religion. Otherwise, people, everybody would have left their religion, become Jehovah's Witnesses. The Muslims, the Catholics, the Baptists, Pentecostal, the Mormons, every single body. Because remember, 1918, Jehovah let his son come down to earth invisibly to check out all the religions and chose the Bible students. But we had a problem. You had one man came in and kicked some of the board of directors out. I think there was 5 or 6 he kicked out that was teaching or kept the teaching of Charles T. Russell. And the rest of the Bible students was gradually even watchtower because they didn't want to believe in the new doctrines or new lies and break away from the original teaching. Isn't that what they're saying about the apostates breaking away from the true teaching and forming a new religion? And destroying God's word. Isn't that what Judge Rutherford did with the Bible students that believed him over the original teachings of Charles T. Russell? So could it be possible that the Bible students today may have good teaching compared to Watchtower's teaching? You don't hear on the news that the Bible students is shunning like Jehovah's Witnesses. You don't hear them how many people died of blood transfusion. But see, I'm not saying the Bible students is the true religion. I'm just saying they're not more evil than Watchtower, what it is today. So it probably would have been better for Watchtower stay with the original teaching of Charles T. Russell. Maybe there would be no pedophiles in this organization. Maybe people wouldn't be committing suicide if they was Bible students. So, who is more evil? The ones who left the organization or the ones who stayed in this organization? Who was more evil? Was it the Bible students leaving the new teaching to become Jehovah Witnesses? Or was it Jehovah Witnesses became more evil by leaving their first teaching? You need to decide that, people. I have learned about the Bible Students Movement. Having never stumbled, nothing compared what has been worldwide of the members of the congregations of Jehovah's Witnesses. It's more evil than most religions. Because there is no knowledge becoming a Jehovah's Witness. There is never going to be a good reason to join this religion. And the last part of the paragraph fits everything, the reason why all of us are leaving this false religion. It's pure evil. Evil brings death, sorrow, pain. And I just brought out parts every human being who left this organization have seen different traits. A pain, death, sorrow, mentally breaking down, unable to function as a human being because of this evil organization. Now, I gave you a reason, hopefully, to wake you up. The tree of life will not and never help Jehovah's Witnesses unless you leave this false, doctrinated, corrupt organization, pretending to be a religion, pretending to be the only truth for you to get to eternal life. People, it's not there. It never will be. This religion started downhill when Charles T. Russell had it. And then it dug a giant deep hole at the bottom of that hill. And Jehovah's Witnesses, we fell through it. And it's Christ's will and the Holy Spirit is helping us to crawl out of that hole that we fell in. Hook, line, and sinker, by thinking this is the knowledge and the good the Bible warned Adam what was going to happen if he did not obey his law, staying away from that tree. That tree today is Watchtower Bible Tract Society. That tree that we've been eating is pure evil. Read God's Word. Don't take my mind for it. Read God's Word. Go to Bible Hub. Pick up a different Bible. The NWT is not God's Word. You can learn the truth in there, but why take a poison book when it says what God told Adam, the knowledge, the good, and the evil? The knowledge of knowing that is not the Bible. The good, you're learning the true knowledge and recognize the evil of the silver sword, the organization corrupted now by 8 men. Your life, you can crawl out of that deep hole that you fell in and start crawling out like we did by coming to Christ and His Father by using a real Bible. And that's where you'll gain true knowledge. And you could be thinking good that you did the right thing for yourself by leaving the evil, like destroy Adam, destroying every single Jehovah Witness who stays in that kingdom hall. That's all I gotta say. Choice is yours. Thank you very much. And I hope this video will enlighten you, encourage you to seek professional help by using God's Word, the real Bibles, like the King James, and praying to Jesus. Praying to Jesus will help you to understand what we have learned. And I hope this video will help you to get there. I'm throwing a rope down in that hole, and many people is behind me is trying to pull you out of that hole. All you have to do is grab the rope, and we'll pull you out of that hole of the lies of Watchtower. But it's you gonna have to have courage and faith and give yourself a chance to understand there's people out there is throwing everything down to you to bring you out of pure evil. We're giving you good by giving you a rope to give you the knowledge to grab hold of it and let us pull you out of Watchtower's false doctrines, teachings, and this evil, corrupt organization. The power is in your hands right now. Grab hold of the spiritual rope where you are deep in this hole of being brainwashed of this organization. Let us guide you. Just grab hold of it. Let us help you, just like we was helped to get out. Remember, by that verse, knowledge, good, will get you out of the evil that you are in with Watchtower. Thank you very much. Video is over 35 minutes, but it was worth making this video. Now, if you agree with me, please open the door of true knowledge. Guarantee it will be good, and you will laugh all the way to the bank because you left the pure evil behind. Thank you very much for watching this video, and y'all, thank you very much from the bottom of my heart to be part of your lives. Goodbye for now.